Ha! The game crashed on me. That's the first time that a game that I recorded ever has crashed. That's probably a lie, but it sounds better. At least I found out why it crashed. Because apparently I ran out of disk space in my external hard drive whilst I was just recording, and that apparently kills the game. I freed up some space, I should be able to at least record, well, at least half an hour more video. I'm not gonna play for more than half an hour, this is gonna be the last part. If nothing interesting happens, that is. Anyways, let's talk to Skelter.
Well, if it ain't the talk of the town.
How do I know his name is Skelter? I know his name is Skelter.
What does the prince have his
we also know his name is Skelter.
Today?
I'll show you why in a second. The jester plays his little game and sends his little pawn before him.
Jester? What the hell did you say? You're Malkavian, right?
Yep. It always takes everyone a while to notice that, and when they do, it's like, oh shit. Maybe not as crazy as look. Greetings, Helter Skelter. That's actually very fun. Look at this.
Damn. Malkavians and a goddamn insight. That shit is creepy.
Indeed.
Anyway, yeah. My name is Skelter. I do my part to keep California a free state for the Anarchs.
Woohoo, go Anarchs. I see he of the name of numbers.
So then go on up and see it. You're free to do as you please here.
Well, have fun. When I get to the bottom, I'll go back to the top for the slide. Off the slide. Yada yada. Can I make up the... No, just the volume overall. Eisenhower quality, I don't care to mess with it now. It's not necessary to insert it now. Anyway, I'm gonna quick save in case it crashes after this again. Because after I speak to him, that's when it crashed. So it didn't save that part of the video.
What's up?
I seek wisdom about... No, wait. Have you deeds that need to be done?
This girl's been making a lot of noise lately. She's a real pain in the ass. She's a ghoul of this one Toreador creep who disappeared.
Oh, nice. What is the name of this ghoulish girl?
Her name is Pat. She hangs out in the clubs downtown. She used to show up around here and act like she was everybody's best friend. It was all fun and games until her vampire sugar daddy stopped calling. Now she can't get her blood fixed and shit ain't so fun no more.
What dark needs to be done?
She's crossed the line. Only time that mouth ain't blabbing is when it's sucking vampire blood. She's gotta disappear. Do this, and we'll keep it our little secret, you hear?
Sure, if we didn't speak loud enough, everyone hear us. I will take this mission. No, wait. I will serve the Shield of Entropy.
Alright, have fun. I'd love to do this one myself, but I know it's silent. Just let me know when it's done.
So he's not actually away. He is not like her anymore. I shall pursue the streets with this little patty. Farewell. Hamburger? Oh, wait. Oh, hey, nice.
You showed up. Good. Here's what I gotta tell you. And so you know, I don't lecture, I don't rap, I'm no bureaucrat.
Yet you're talking
I'm
like
just
one.
A guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me.
Oh, sweet. More.
You got a right to know the score. The Camarilla, this is the short of it. They operate a lot like a pyramid scheme. There's a bunch of these old-timers at the top with God only knows what plots in mind. They lose their power, they die. They sire
nice.
More to carry out their plans. And looking for a little power than those kindred sired for their own schemes and so on and on and on. It hurts my head just thinking about the mess.
There's my head up
and
the
it works out to is this.
In general.
Only a few people at the top have any real power.
Aren't we all just one big happy family in Camarilla? No, wait, not. I would leave my head to listen, but I must go when they're... No, wait. Aren't we all just one big happy family named Camarilla?
Them's fighting words, newbie. But you're young and stupid, so I won't make an example out of you. See, the Camarilla claims all of us are members, even if we don't want to be. Which is, of course, the biggest little horseshit a man ever heard.
We're not actually people anymore. We are. Let me hear your truth.
I learned the way of this world during the Depression. Bunch of old rich bastards screwed the country. But did they suffer? No. The little people suffered.
As always.
You can't trust the people at the top. The world would be a better place without them. All you can do is get a group of people together who aren't assholes. Find a place to put your feet up and make some examples of the quote-unquote elite to keep the rest the hell out. Everyone's an equal here. The same thing this country used to be about. That's what LA has been. An anarch-free state.
Well, one for the vampires. The Camarilla is a sapling here?
The Camarilla was kicked out on their ass a long time ago. We, the anarchs, didn't want to play their politics anymore. Now LaCroix and crew pop in like they never left? No goddamn way. Their laws don't apply to us.
Sweet. You mean they can kill anyone? You and Prince don't go golf on weekends?
LaCroix represents everything I hate. The Camarilla, stuck-up aristocrats, rich businessmen, crooked politicians. The only place LaCroix belongs is in an urn.
How nice. You are the Prince of Thieves and these are your merry men?
Don't use me and Prince in the same sentence, Malk. I fought to keep LA free since I was embraced. Long time later, I'm one of the only ones left that hasn't bitted or switched sides. The most veteran soldier on the battlefield.
How nice. Meet with them, baloney all around.
I got their meeting right here.
My mind is still soft. In shape, I should say to them, you look angry as shit.
Here's what I tell all the new blood. One, you get careless, that blood will make you into a monster. If you rampage around here, you get put down. Two, don't kill when you feed. No reason to. In this city, there's lots of ways to slake the beast without leaving a trail of dead.
Three,
the Camarilla's full of shit. Four, watch your back, always. And lastly, learn how to fight. Because a speech ain't gonna save your ass when you're staring down the barrel of a shotgun.
No, but turning invisible and speaking crazy, definitely will. Teach me the razzmatazz.
After picking your ass up off the pavement back there, yeah. I can tell you don't even know the basics. Hold your hands up like this, and keep your body at an angle. It makes you harder to hit. Keep your thumbs out of your fists and put your weight into your punches.
You're using words, I will savor them.
You poor bastard. Listen, LA's the school of hard knocks, so keep your friends close and your enemies in a barbecue pit.
That's proper.
Once you square things with LaCroix, don't give that son of a bitch the time of night. I got my eye on you, kid.
Eek, squishy. Escape. We will talk to her later, and Jack later. For now, we will go and solve this patty problem. Yes, that was my fist. No, we're not gonna beat her up. I just do that because I felt like it. And I wanted to give her the impression that I was gonna kill her. We are not gonna kill her. I'm not even sure if she's actually gonna die. Well, to be honest, if things don't work out, yes, then we will kill her. If things go as I planned, we won't kill her. Isn't that fun? Aw, damn it, I should have looked up when we could do the mod quest. You guys are gonna have to wait till the end of this sitting to find to see one of them. I mean, you already see some of the changes. I mean, he said something about we could do things before we went to LaCroix. I will check that out before I go to LaCroix because I don't want to mess things up, you know. Anyways, we've spoken to Nines. We killed the bear. Well, grizzly. Whatever. Oh, what was I gonna do? Yeah, the patty brawl problem. Get out of my way, Hummins. Hunger can induce frenzy, as can fear the anger caused by taking physical damage. Sometimes that can be good. Anyway, let's quick save before we talk to upstuck bitch here.
I knew you'd talk to me. I swear you were all like totally drawn to me. I'm surprised I don't know you. I usually meet all the L.A. vampires out on the scene. Not a lot of you out tonight, which is weird, because I don't know of any parties going on.
They are trying to keep as far away from you as possible. You could not be more strange, stranger.
No, come on. It's totally cool. I'm Patty. Seriously, everyone knows me. Besides, I just wanted to ask you if you've seen someone.
Someone? Always, everywhere, with names unknown.
His name is Kent Allen Ryan. He's a toreador. Really good looking, dresses really well, like all Prada usually.
How sweet. Oh yes, a toreador groomed like a show cat? Yes, I have beheld him.
You are totally awesome.
Don't make that
just
face.
Just to show you that you don't have to dress cute or care what you look like to be a cool girl.
I wanna punch you.
So, where is Kent?
I wanna rip out your guts and, he raves, no, plans a rave in Santa Monica's blood bank.
Oh, that is totally Kent. He's so like that. I better go find him. He needs my help to do anything. Thanks again.
I'm sure he'll be happy to have his pet back. Yeah. You remember when we told Vamblet we was gonna get him someone new to get all the blood from? Well, problem solved. And we did something good for Anarchs in the meantime. Your message was delivered, Goddess.
I can't hear you! Let's talk in my office!
You could totally hear me before, nothing has changed. Ah, the office. Yes.
Well, you certainly did better than my bouncer did. Poor dear can't turn his neck to the right anymore. Already
okay.
Paul from Boris wasn't too happy about tonight, son of a bitch. Say, would you like to get into the club business? Hmm?
Yes, I witnessed the speaking someone in the background. Boris?
To start this club, I had to take out a significant loan from a king bastard by the name of Boris, and every time I haven't been able to make the monthly plus interest, the bastard takes what he feels is a suitable late fee.
Let me guess what that is. Babble to like exhaustion, Goddess.
I've got a club to run, so I'll be blunt. I refuse to fuck that.
Yeah, that is being blunt.
Old man, one more time to hold on to the club. So I need someone to eliminate him.
Sounds proper.
Do this, and I'll make you a silent partner.
I don't know if I'll be that silent, but I've become Mars to save you from Vulcan, Logos.
He's at the Empire Hotel. Always has a few of the fiercest bully boys standing around trying to out-sneer each other. He's got a short temper, and more than likely he's been drinking for the last 4 hours.
Oh, he's Russian, isn't he?
To the penthouse level.
Yes, the SARS reign will end shortly. Tsar, of course, being a Russian emperor in the old days. Now, which way is the exit? That direction. I could just jump down and move away, but what fun is that when there's entertainment up here? Indeed. And there's, of course, entertainment down here. In the form of a computer that we can totally read emails on. Unread emails on my dad. Slave. Right. Thought we might get together tonight if it pleases you, mistress. From Larry? What if it's Larry? Next. Venus, your father wanted me to write you to tell that he has a boil that is 3 inches across. Long 10 centimeters. You really need to come home and visit, see this thing. Love, Mom. That's creepy. Right. Oh, hey, look, it's blood on. You can't sneed my hands. Oh, that's a bad one. It looks like you need refill. Can I drink it?
Are you undressing me with your eyes? Got a picture in your head? Good. That's as close as you're ever gonna come to seeing me naked.
I didn't see you naked, so you drink your blood. Second one?
Are you undressing me with your eyes?
Fuck you. I'll come back later when I have higher seduction. So that's how we look now? No wonder she doesn't really want to talk to us. Where's seduction? Subterfuge work? Yes, it does. No, I'm at 4.
Good. That's as close as you're ever gonna come to seeing me naked.
Oh, shut up if I drink your blood involuntarily. The voice. Oh, god damn it, it makes it even hard to read. The voice from your head is even more angelic than the voice in mine.
So, who are you?
I'm crazy. I am your you, that's who. That's not how you move your mouth when you giggle. Hey, have you ever left without his... let me forget what I said. Like I said, we completely look like a prostitute. Completely and utterly. Anyways, that will be the end of the video. Next time we come back, we will go and beat this Boris fellow up. Or make him shoot himself, I don't know. Insanity can make people do crazy things. So it's insanity. Wow, your face is really just painted on. It's not really any eyes or anything. That's because you're an unimportant person to the plot and the game in general. Just like the... no, wait, they actually have eyes. Anyways, next time we come back, I will make sure that I have more space on my hard drive. And I will shut you up. I know I'm out of video. And I don't care. because I am finishing the video. Anyways, like I said, next time we will go beat up Boris. I will clear more space, we can make a video without having crash and me losing progress. I will save. It's not to redo that mistake. Alright, no. There, male, female. Save over that one, and there we go. Anyways, I'll see you next time. And we're gonna do everything I said before. Bye.